You're watching CW50 News at 10.
Going to hold people responsible for betraying the trust we put in them to protect our children.
Right now at 10 o'clock, victims of the Oxford High School shooting taking their grief to court. What's next now for the families and the school a week after the tragedy? Good evening, everyone. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. I'm Ken Molestina. It's only been a little over a week since that tragedy when bullets rang out during peak school hours, leaving four students dead. 15-year-old Ethan Crumbly is accused of carrying out the attack with a weapon taken from his father. He faces both terrorism and murder charges. His parents have also been charged with involuntary manslaughter. Their first hearings are set for later this month. But tonight, the anger and the pain still fresh for the families of all of the victims. One of them now hitting Oxford Community Schools with a $100 million lawsuit, accusing the district of not doing enough to protect students. CW50's April Morton reports.
High-profile attorney Geoffrey Fieger says chances are school officials in Oxford will not be held criminally responsible for the Oxford shooting. However, he's hitting them hard in the pockets with a multi-million dollar lawsuit.
We're going to hold people responsible for betraying the trust we put in them to protect our children.
During a press conference Thursday, Fieger discussed the filing of two $100 million lawsuits against the Oxford Community School District and several Oxford High School staff members.
There is a responsibility among teachers, counselors, and school administrators who could easily have prevented and stopped the slaughter.
Fieger says accused Oxford shooter Ethan Crumbly was obviously disturbed and homicidal based on drawings he made depicting students being shot. Among other disturbing actions, he says school officials were aware of prior to the shooting. In the lawsuit, Fieger is representing the Franz family, whose 17-year-old daughter Riley was shot in the neck during the massacre, and her sister, 14-year-old Bella, was not injured but witnessed her sister get shot during the tragic event that left four of their classmates dead.
This should have been a time in which they're preparing to go on Christmas vacation. Instead, Riley's spending her time convalescing and packing a wound with a neck wound that less than 2% of people who suffer that wound survive. And Bella's been literally traumatized as if she was surviving in a war zone.
School officials have not responded to the suit. In Southfield, April Morton, CW50, News at 10.